Tim Bailey joins us now with the weather, of course, and a special message too. We know surf lifesavers work very hard, but harder than you think. Not only saving lives on the coast, Tim, but they're moving inland now.
Yeah, they are, and it's my fine pleasure, Bill, to welcome Zane Holmes, a two-time World Ironman champion and ambassador of a brilliant... Gee, this is a good initiative, isn't it? Telstra Beach to the Bush. So we are taking our life-saving knowledge out to country areas. So we're not only saving lives in dams and rivers and creeks, but when the kids come out this away, they know something about a rip. You must be proud to be involved in this.
I am. I'm extremely proud. It's... You know, the Telstra Beach to Bush program has been running many years now, and we've taught so many kids from the bush what to do when they come to the beach. So, and obviously the biggest message is swim between those red and yellow flags.
It is, but it must be nice. Telstra's done a good job. They've pumped lots of money into surf life saving, into the clubs, into equipment, all of that. But this is taking knowledge out to the country. A lot of them come this way at Christmas time, would never have seen a rip, rarely get sand beneath their toes, zinc cream on their nose. So we are literally saving lives. And we've spoken to a whole heap of kids this year alone. How many?
Yeah, this year we'll probably be targeting around 50,000 school-age kids right through regional Australia. So, you know, we'll be teaching them things like how to identify rips, what are the safety signs, and basically if there's anything they need to know when they come to the beach, go and ask the lifesavers in the red and yellow cap.
It's terrific. So we're taking our wonderful culture of the surf out to the bush. Thanks very much, mate.
Thanks for
having me. Two-times world champion Ironman. Pleasure for me to meet you. All right, what do we got, folks? Well, no storm warning tonight for the Sydney metropolitan area. As we go to air, though, the central west slopes and plains are looking rather boom, crash, opera. Also, the mid-north coast of New South Wales, the Hunter and the Illawarra have had thunderstorm warnings. The next 72 hours in New South Wales will very much be on thunderstorm watch. It looks like we won't get rid of this pattern until Friday, but when it goes, it's going to be glorious. Big blue skies and the warmest temperatures since last summer. Let's get into your backyard for you right now. And 23 degrees Gosford, Richmond 25, 21 Sydney. The wind easterly 16k an hour. Bailey's barometer 1023. 18 degrees in the deep blue sea. Satellite, cloud over eastern Northern Territory, Queensland and New South Wales in a trough, generates isolated thunderstorms and showers. Map tomorrow, broad inland trough will trigger thundery showers over Queensland and New South Wales. Rain fall, showers and storms for much of New South Wales, but falls will generally be less than 10 millimetres. Then, Friday, we burst into blue sky. The weekend, 28 to 33 degrees on Saturday, and Sunday, up into around about 35 or 36 degrees in the greater west. Let's go into state for you right now. Tomorrow in Brisbane, a clearing shower 26, Hobart late shower, sunny in Adelaide, possible shower Perth, possible shower Melbourne, sunny in the Alice. Thunderstorms, Tamworth, Dubbo, Orange, Newcastle, 72-hour alert we're on. Nowra and Bega, storms likely. Gosford 28, 30 Richmond, 28 Bankstown. Sydney tomorrow, northerly to northwest winds, possible showers and storms from late morning until evening, tops of 26. 5:47 sunrise, setting at 7:32. Possible storm Thursday, then mostly sunny Friday, Saturday, Sunday, showers Monday and Tuesday. 72 more hours of thunderstorms for New South Wales and then the best weekend since summer. I'll see you again tomorrow night.
Thank you, Tim. That's 10 News for now. I'm Sandra Sully.
I'm Bill Woods. Thanks for being with us. Updates tonight.
Late news, 10:30. See you tomorrow. Good night. Good night.